everyone. My name is Alain Fayolle. I am pleased to be there to tell you about a big hot topic, which is entrepreneurship. First of all, I would like to introduce my agenda. A few words about myself, who I am. Then we'll develop around what does it mean, entrepreneurship domain. It's a big question. And then developing ideas about the main dimensions in entrepreneurship, followed by strong convictions, my strong convictions. And the last part of my talk will be on free conceptualization of entrepreneurship before to give a short conclusion. So I'm a professor at EM Lyon Business School, one of the best European business school, mainly in the field of entrepreneurship. I'm also the director of the Entrepreneurship Research Center, and I've been or is still visiting professor in European universities and also in universities outside Europe. I'm still active in scientific associations in France and in Europe. And finally, I'm an expert for governments, OECD, etc. So, what does it mean, entrepreneurship? As I said, it's really a big question because we can hear different things about it. We can read different definitions. And I would like to start with two quotations who come from a couple of very good scholars in entrepreneurship. The first is from Richard Harrison and Claire Leitch in 1996. They said, "We are asked regularly, what do you do? And we reply, I'm teacher of entrepreneurship or I'm an entrepreneurship researcher. Almost invariably, this provokes a follow-up question. What is entrepreneurship? What exactly do you do? What's your job?" Which asks us to define, explain, give more details about what we are doing. This is not, it must be noted, a situation faced by others, for example, pilots, teachers, or physics, or students in medicine, and so on. The second quotation comes from Howard Stevenson, Harvard Business School professors. Like Richard Harrison and Claire Leitch, he was regularly asked about what does entrepreneurship mean, and his answer was, "Oh, you know, it's really simple. Entrepreneurship is like an intellectual onion. You take it, you peel it layer by layer, and when you get to the center, is nothing but you are crying." So it's it gives really a good idea about the difficulty we have in approaching, conceptually speaking, in defining entrepreneurship. To bring overviews in order to get a good understanding about entrepreneurship, I would like to relate the concept to other notions which are really important. The first is uncertainty. Entrepreneurship is something which relates to uncertainty, and behind uncertainty there are risks individuals may take in acting as entrepreneur in different situations and contexts. Also, entrepreneurship can be seen through the lenses of heterogeneity. It means that we have a lot of entrepreneurial behaviors, we have different entrepreneurial situations, and we cannot approach them with the same kind of models or tools or ideas. Entrepreneurship is also changes for individuals and environments. Individuals have to learn when they act as entrepreneurs because they have to solve problems, they have to deal with new things, and then doing them, then solving the problems, they learn a lot. And the learning capacity is probably among the most important for entrepreneurs. Entrepreneurship is also growth, and it's really a strong expectation from societies and policymakers, which encourage entrepreneurs, would-be entrepreneurs, to create new firms and to grow them. The outcome is also the creation of new jobs, and finally, it's probably the most important thing, the creation of new value at the societal and economic level. To talk about entrepreneurship differently, addressing key situations, we can talk about entrepreneurship in terms of the creation of new firms, in terms of corporate entrepreneurship. It means developing new projects, turning ideas into opportunities in the context of existing organizations, developing more among different categories of people, employees, entrepreneurial mindset. Entrepreneurship is also linked to social problems, bringing solutions to social problems. It's called social entrepreneurship in this case. It's also acquiring and dynamizing existing businesses. And finally, we can see entrepreneurship probably much more modestly through self-employment, the creation of her or his own job by people under necessity. Sometimes it means they are unemployed. To sum up to a certain extent, key dimensions in entrepreneurship are, for the first one, and it's a much more important, individual. Entrepreneurship can occur and develop because individuals have intention, have desire to become entrepreneurs. And from idea, go to action and do things. It can also concern small team. That's the first dimension. Also, environment plays a great role in entrepreneurship, and it's probably through the interaction between individual and their environment that entrepreneurial process can develop. Ideas can turn into opportunities and new companies, things like that. The third dimension is organization. It's probably really difficult to do things without an organization. It means recruiting people, defining objectives for each member of the team, and then controlling the successful of actions and achieving objectives, think like that. Building up an organization within the entrepreneurial process is really something important. And finally, the process itself. The process means that to turn an idea into an opportunity, time is really important, because time allows individual to learn, to become more successful, to find the good solutions regarding the problems, the issues they have. Time is also important for giving the chance to people in a team, in an entrepreneurial team, to achieve the objectives and to become stronger and better. So we have here the four important dimensions when talking about entrepreneurship, of course, from my point of view. Next point, we have always convictions when doing things, acting as entrepreneurs, researching in the field of entrepreneurship, teaching people, educating people in entrepreneurship. From my point of view, the context is really, really key in entrepreneurship. And I like these two quotations from Alistair Anderson, professor at Aberdeen Business School. First, he's stating that entrepreneurship is a contextual event, and it's also the outcome of many influences. It underlines the fact that a given context has some big consequences towards entrepreneurship, towards entrepreneurial behaviors. Some things are possible in some context, others not. And the second quotation is about the fact that the process of entrepreneurship is a matter of individual and context. It can be seen as something really obvious or simple, but it's important to say that and to say again, because sometimes we forget simple things and we make failures. We make mistakes, and we can fail because we have forgotten simple things. Now, to end up my talk, I would like to introduce three conceptualizations of entrepreneurship. The most dominant is probably who's around the notion of opportunities. Opportunity is a key element in the entrepreneurship phenomenon. What does it mean, an opportunity? It means I've seen something to do in a market, in an environment. Some needs are not fulfilled, and there is a room to do something, to develop a new product, a new service in order to achieve the needs. So the definition which is given by Shen and Venkataraman is the following. For them, the scholarly examination, entrepreneurship, is the scholarly examination of how, by whom, and with what effects opportunity to create new goods and services are discovered, evaluated, and exploited. The three words are important: the discovery, the evaluation, and the exploitation of opportunities to create new goods and new services. For them, it means, among other things, that the field is really on the sources of opportunities and the way we can get these sources, and then the processes I talked about to evaluate, exploit the opportunities. The second conceptualization of entrepreneurship is quite different. It's not focusing on opportunities, but on emergence. Entrepreneurship is seen here at the emergence of a new organization. It means a process, the creative process sometimes, which leads to the creation of a new organization. And it comes from Bill Gartner, who is an American and probably one of the most influential scholars in entrepreneurship. Finally, the third conceptualization of entrepreneurship has been proposed by a French, Christian Brouillat, and I fully agree with them. I like this conceptualization, and I'm using very often in my research, in my teaching, this way to talk about entrepreneurship. It's a mainly specific relationship, which is called a dialogic between an individual and the new value creation process. It means that the individual is at the source of the new value creation, and the new value creation influences individual at the different step of the process. And we have to see this dialogic in dynamic of changes. Again, we are talking about changes. It's a key word in entrepreneurship. And here, changes affects individuals. I talk about the necessity and the capacity to learn a lot of things very quickly, and also the concerned environment. I would like now to give a short conclusion, always taking a quotation from other influential scholar, Pierre Davidson. He wrote, starting from assumptions of uncertainty and heterogeneity, the scholarly domain of entrepreneurship encompasses the processes of emergence of new business venture across organization context. You can see here some of the keywords I was talking about during this talk. Thank you for your attention.